This video is going to explore creating a chart from written input. So what I'm going to do is click on the first icon in the toolbar, or you can click on File, New and New Written Instructions. And you want to select the folder and file name and chart title to suit. So I'll use this folder, that's fine. Call this text input number one and new chart with text input. Click finish and the input area appears. So it's already given us our chart title that we've typed in previously, but we can't change this if wanted. And you can either start typing, or if you have written instructions already typed out, you can copy and paste. So in Notepad, we have this set of instructions. So I copy using my keyboard and paste. A couple of things to note here. These instructions are for a flat piece of knitting, which is why the word row has been used. If you use the word round, you'll obviously get a circular piece of knitting. You don't have to put in right side and wrong side. If you leave this blank and it's for flat knitting, then the first row will be assumed to be the right side row. But of course, if you want the first row to be the wrong side row, you will need to type that in. Something else to note is that you don't have to use capital letters at the start of each line of text, but the stitches should be separated by commas and you need to finish each row with a full stop. Let's have a quick play. So all of these instructions are right, and I can tell that because there's no cross alert here in the left of the text. There's no errors being found. And something that is sometimes quite useful is the link with editor tool. So at the moment I have that toggled on, you can tell because the background is a different colour. But if I click again, then the background blends in with the rest of the background and you can tell it's not switched on. So blue background means that it is actually functioning, and this means that if I click on any stitch in the input area here, it will find that stitch in the outline. And similarly, if I click on a row or a specific stitch in the outline view, it will highlight it in the text input. So that can be helpful if you're working through a lot of instructions and trying to find your place. Something that we can try doing is what happens if there's a mistake. When you put in your abbreviations, they need to be the abbreviations that are recognised by Stitchmastery. And of course, this does mean that you might have mistakes from time to time if your chosen abbreviations are slightly different to what the software has in its database. So, for instance, it's unlikely that you would abbreviate a purl stitch with PU, but if we had that, we see that we get an error. And it says, couldn't find stitch PU1. And if we hover over that stitch, we get the same issue here. Now, for some issues, it will provide an immediate alternative. In this case, it's not. But what we can do is delete the full stitch. Now, because we deleted the stitch, we get a new error, which says, looks as if you have either missed out a row, round or stitch, or added an extra comma, which technically, it could be either the comma or a missing stitch. If we come down to the outline view, we can see the difference between our row 5 is 11 columns consuming and producing 11, whereas the rest of the rows are giving us 12 stitches. So let's just pop P1 back in. There may be a time where you can't quite work out what the abbreviation should be for a stitch. So for instance, maybe your slip slip knit stitch, you might be expecting something different. There is a tool within the software called Content Assist, which helps you with this. So say for instance, I knew that the first letter should be S, but I can't remember the rest. I can activate Content Assist by pushing down my control button on my keyboard and the space bar, and that opens up a dialogue with all of the stitches that begin with S, so everything that I could possibly be looking for. Click on it and then hit your enter button, and that places it into your written input. And just to be clear, you want to have your cursor at the exact place before you turn on the Content Assist. So Content Assist is no longer functioning because we've found the right thing. You could do that before typing anything. So if I had couldn't remember at all what slip knit would be, or I just wanted to see what stitches there were available at all, so Control and Spacebar, without typing anything at all, you'll get a full list of all of the abbreviations to choose from, and they're in alphabetical order, so numbers first and then everything else in alphabetical order. Something else that I'm going to try adding, at the moment this chart will be all one size, 12 stitches wide all the way up. But if we add in row 13, now we immediately get an error because we've not finished the row. Well, at the moment we haven't put any stitches in, but we've also not finished the row with a full stop. So you could just say letter P for purl the whole row, or it should be a K for knit. And because we've got the full stop, you remove the error message. You can't just have the letter K, you need the full stop to finish the row. But let's make this a K to tog, then knit the remaining 10 stitches. So my row is consuming 12 but producing 11. And what will happen in the chart itself, because Stitchmastery doesn't know what to do with the final stitch, what it will do by default is to add a cross no stitch symbol at the end of the row. But we might decide that actually we want to place the no stitch at the start of the row and then go on to add additional no stitches. So we just type no stitch, and then you can see that the cross has been added here before the knit two together. So let's go to generating a new chart. You can either use the icon at the end of the icon bar for new chart diagram, or you can come to File, New, and New Chart Diagram from Written Instructions. And this dialog is very similar to the chart diagram setup that you get if you're starting a normal chart in Stitchmastery. So we've already set the folder, and I'm going to set the file name as something similar, so text input number one, same title as the text file, but obviously it has a text extension, whereas this will be a knit2 file, so different extensions, so they can have the same name. The chart title has come in, and you have no control over the row or columns because you've set that by the stitches that you've put in your written instructions. So it's picking up that we've got 13 rows, we've got 12 columns because the widest row has 12 stitches. And it's picked up that the chart type is flat and the first row is a right side row. So click finish to generate the chart. And as we see, we have a fully generated chart. All of our stitches as input, including our no stitch at the start of that row 13. And we have our written instructions in the output text exactly as we would expect to see them. And of course you can now start changing things. So for instance, I might want to change my no stitch to the grey no stitch symbol instead. And if we change our view to the outline view, we'll see that there are no errors.